I just wanted to make this video and ask a good question for people today. Where would you be without Yeshua, the one they call Jesus? If you believe in him and you know him and you know what he's done for you, did you ever think where you would be without him? I don't even want to imagine where I would be without him, because I grew up without him and I didn't know him. And my life was nothing like it is now. My life is so blessed abundantly today because I know not only did I have a creator who gave his son to die for me, but I know it. And I'm living it. I'm living it. I'm understanding it. And I'm letting other people know it, because that's what we're called to do. There are so many people in the world today that are living without him. And when you ask the question, where would we be without him, or where would you be? Well, you can just look at the news today and look at what's going on in the world today and you see where we are, because so many people are without him. So many people don't want to know him. So many people refuse him. And I tell you, the answer is not in drugs. The answer is not in money. The answer is not in going to see a psychiatrist. The answer is opening up your Bible, reading the gospel, and understanding Yeshua died for us, doing something that we didn't even deserve, setting us free from death row. And we need to accept Yeshua, and we need to repent. So repentance is changing your ways and changing your life. And when you believe in Yeshua, you do that. And you know, many people have to hit rock bottom for that to happen. And I mean rock bottom. I mean rock bottom. But you don't have to do that. You know, you have time now. There's still time to know this. There's me here telling you right now, and there's a lot of people telling you this truth. When I was growing up without him and I didn't know him, and I was in New York City doing my hustle and bustle, I met many people on the streets proclaiming Yeshua, the one they called Jesus, as Messiah, who died for us. And I just walked past and I ignored him. And I'm so glad I didn't hit rock bottom, but I hit the bottom. And you know, it's unfortunate that some people have to do that. So many people find Yeshua, the one they call Jesus, after near-death experiences, or if they're in jail, or if they in the hospital or somewhere else. My question to you is, why wait? If you don't know who he is, why wait? Why not accept him now? Why not take that chance? Because I tell you, look, you think there's many different paths and many different roads to salvation, but the Bible says there's only one way, and that is through Yeshua. There's a narrow road, which is following his guidelines and instructions, that lead to the narrow gate, which is Yeshua. And many people think they know that, but it says only few will find it. And the Bible is a set of instructions that's given to us, the greatest autobiography in the world. And we need to understand, when they say history, it's his story. And we see that and we realize that. And I'm telling you right now, if you're out there and you don't know who Yeshua is, the one they call Jesus, you know, first thing you need to do is repent, change your life around, and let your heart change, and then accept Yeshua as your Messiah, because he did die for you, whether you believe it or not, whether you know it or not, or whether you care or not. So he died for you that you would change. And I guarantee one thing, that if you repent and accept Yeshua, your life will change, and you will no longer have to think about or answer that question, where would you be without him? You can just be thankful that you're not there anymore, and your life has changed. So hallelujah. You know, there's no other path, there's no other way other than Yeshua, the one they call Jesus. And that's it. And some people could ask, what about all these different gods, and what about all these other so-called gods of the world and everything else? But you know what? Yahweh is the name of the creator, and there's only one. And all these other so-called gods of this world, well, they proclaim things that go against the words of our creator. So I know my creator, Yahweh, gave me the instructions of how to live, and his son was resurrected, came back up from the grave. You know, my God, my creator, was somebody who died for me so I could have salvation and another chance at life. We need to get this right, folks. We need to understand there's only one way, one truth, and one life, and that is Yeshua, the one they call Jesus. And I understand it's pleasing to know there are many other paths in this world to our flesh, but we're not here to please the flesh. We're here to please our wonderful creator. At least that's why I'm here, and that's why you should be here. So where would we be without him? You know, it's something we shouldn't even have to think about, but unfortunately we can just look around the world and see that that's what's happening in today's world. Hallelujah means praise our wonderful creator, Yahweh, the one and only way to salvation through his son Yeshua, the one they call Jesus. That's the only way, folks. And you have an opportunity to realize that, accept that, believe that, or you could be like much of this world and deny that and continue to live in your misery, continue to live in your fear of the world, continue to live with your drugs, continue to live with you're working so hard to build these riches here on earth that are going to get you nowhere. We need to store riches up in heaven, folks, and we need to understand the difference between that. And the answer is to the question, where would you be without him? Well, we talk about hell, and that's where you'd be without him, hell, and that's what life is, and that's what eternity is. Without him, it's hell. And the opposite of that is heaven, folks. And I'm living the greatest life in the world because we have a wonderful King who died for us. Hallelujah. And there's no other way. There's no other way. So stop listening to the false prophets out there. Praise Yahweh, the only way to salvation. And we need to get this. We need to get this right.